Central and West Africa is getting a big reputation for some very interesting mining projects, and Aussie-listed Equatorial Resources is in this area. It's in the Republic of Congo as an explorer and development company with two 100% owned iron ore assets. Well, John Welborn is the chief executive and joins us now. John, welcome.
Thanks, Jeremy.
It's been a great success story at Equatorial over the last few years. Tell us how the company stands out from its peers in the iron ore space, at least in this area of Africa.
Well, you're correct that it's a very exciting and emerging space, and where we're increasingly identifying a difference between Equatorial and our many peers in the region is around the quality of the assets, the scale of the opportunity, and particularly for an iron ore company, access to infrastructure.
What about the likely winners and losers in this ongoing boom in this particular area? I mean, are you starting to see some patterns emerging and some key requirements, we say, for success?
Certainly the requirement around transport infrastructure. Iron ore is a bulk commodity and it needs enormous scale. And the key element of that is transport infrastructure, usually in the form of railways and ports. And Mayoko-Moussondji, an iron project that we're working on in the southwest of the Republic of Congo, is located next to an existing bulk commodity railway. And the pattern we're seeing in Africa is that the assets that are getting into production, iron ore value creation, is occurring where there is high-grade iron ore in the ground, close to existing lines of infrastructure. Mm. There are many inspirational projects, and in the long term, there will be the development of new railways and new ports to increase production out of Africa. But certainly the first step is to get into production around existing assets, and that's the opportunity that we're pursuing.
On your road down that route, you've done some metallurgical test work. What has this shown us, and where's this for?
It's been a really positive step. We've got an ongoing drilling program at Mayoko-Moussondji, and part of that drilling program has allowed us to increase our metallurgical test program under the supervision of Dr. John Clout, an industry expert, and we're also doing some bulk sample testing. And what's that showing us is that the ore bodies that we're identifying at Mayoko have the potential to produce a premium product. And by that, we're looking at something above 62% iron with less than 5% combined silica and alumina. And in an increasingly dynamic price environment in the seaborne iron ore market, we see the potential to produce a premium product and therefore demand a premium price as being a very key driver of value.
You got a very strong cash position, $90 million Aussie dollars. This comes out of a deal with Exxaro. Explain what happened there and what are you going to use that cash for?
We purchased a 20% interest in the iron project alongside our tenement at Mayoko. And Exxaro recently completed 100% takeover of that asset. And we accepted their bid and banked $65 million in cash, which increased our cash balance to over $90 million. So a very positive corporate transaction. We'll use that money to accelerate our exploration and development, both at Mayoko and at Badondo. And we're also very delighted to have Exxaro working alongside us. And there's a lot of opportunities for us to cooperate on the ground in day-to-day items like environmental and community management, as well as in the development and operating transport infrastructure required.
You mentioned Badondo. How big a deal is Badondo going to be?
We're really excited. I mean, this is in the remote north of the country. There's a lot of other companies developing very large-scale iron projects in the area. The on-ground work that we've done has demonstrated the potential for that to be one of the key assets in the region. And we're looking forward to getting some results of the drilling program as quickly as we can.
When will we know more about that?
Well, we're starting drilling during the course of June. And we'll look to get the results out during the third quarter. The work we've done on the ground has included rock chip samples from surface as high as 68, 69% iron, so almost pure hematite. And the geophysical survey we've done have indicated an exploration target of more than 2 billion tonnes. Mm. And given the assets in the region, it could be a very significant value driver.
Mm. Some 70% plus of the shareholder base for Equatorial Resources is held by 20 different institutions or individuals. Are you happy with that sort of split? Presumably the rest is just in the market and is traded as a normal stock. Are you happy with that sort of liquidity? Would you like to see more liquidity in the stock?
We'd always welcome new shareholders into Equatorial. We think we've got a very exciting story and also an enormous opportunity to create value. We very much enjoy the very strong support we've had for some key large financial institutions out of the UK. And the next step around around demonstrating the value with our resource statement, indicating the pathway through to production of Mayoko and demonstrating the geological value of Badondo gives a great opportunity for us to create a retail following in the stock.
One final question then. What should investors and potential investors in the stock look out for? What are the signposts to watch for?
I think looking for ongoing drilling results at Mayoko leading into a maiden JORC compliant resource statement and then demonstration of the value of Badondo.
Okay. All right, John. It's a pleasure talking to you. Good luck with all that for this year. John Welborn is the MD and CEO there of Equatorial Resources.
This film is for educational and leisure purposes only. Proactive Investors does not provide investment advice. The company is a publisher and is not registered with or authorized by the Financial Services Authority. Please refer to the full terms and conditions on the Proactive Investors website.